Good afternoon, children. Have you all studied? I think you might have enjoyed the 1 week holidays, isn't it? So now you are getting ready to learn our daily lessons, isn't it? So today in commerce, we will learn the remaining portion in the chapter marketing. Okay, market. We have studied the market and its classification. On different basis, we have learned. Today we will learn marketer. What is the meaning, definition, and role, function, and all we will learn today. Okay, by today we will complete this lesson. So, in short, who is a marketer? Who is a marketer? One who deals in a market, isn't it? One who deals in a market. Or simply we can say he is the seller, isn't it? Or one who is performing the function of marketing. Okay, one who perform the function of marketing. Or one who promotes the exchange of goods and service. Promote exchange of goods and service. Okay, they are the marketers. Understood? So he is a market. Simply says one who sells goods and services is called marketer, or one who deals in a market, or who one who perform the function of marketing, or one who promotes or actually exchange the goods and service. There is one definition given. I will explain and write and explain, because this is one of the very short answer. Second question. Okay, define. Marketer, a person. So we know he is a person whose duties include. So he has two duties. Okay, what are the two duties he has to do? He has to identify the goods and service decided by a set of consumers, and he has to market those goods and services on behalf of the company. That's all. Okay, a person whose duties include the identification of, first he has to identify, identification of goods and services. Identification of the goods and services desired by a set of consumers. Desired means who wish to have, isn't it? Desired by a set of consumers. Because he go to a particular locality. So that set of consumers, there they have. As well as, that one duty is this one. Okay. Duties include the identification of goods and services desired by a set of consumers, as well as the next duty, as well as the marketing of those goods and services. This, okay, of those goods and services on behalf of a company. Because he is working for a company. This meaning is given from the business dictionary. Okay. So this definition you might have understood. Okay. A person whose duties include the first one, identification of the goods and services desired by a set of consumers. Then the next duty, marketing of those goods and services on behalf of a company. Okay, now we will learn what can be marketed. If that question is asked us, we will say only the goods and services, isn't it? Something others are there. Okay, goods, services, and the other we will learn one by one. Okay, first goods. We know what are the goods. Maybe the finished goods, or agricultural goods, or semi-finished goods, electrical goods, isn't it? Machineries, electronic products, all these are the goods that can be marketed. isn't it? These are marketed all over the world, isn't it? So these goods can be marketed, finished goods, or all type of finished goods that we purchase, you know, our household household articles, then machineries, all kinds, then durable goods, even the perishable goods, all are marketed. That will come under this goods heading. Okay, then next one, goods and services. The services are marketed. Services, we can say, they are not dealing with the goods, but they deal with some service that is done to the people, isn't it? That we can say, banking. They never sell something, but they do some service, isn't it, for us? Banking, then insurance companies, then financial institutions, then tourism. When we go to a particular place, you know, they will show us all the place, and they may explain what all the benefits, what is its historical, the background of that place. Everything is marketed. So that services are marketed. The third one is experiences. The experiences are marketed. What we can say, maybe our experience, you know, if a person goes to a particular place in abroad, then he will come and share his experience. If he has seen a place, or if he has attended an event there, event means any program, okay, that, or any park if he has gone, then he may share his experience. That can be marketed in order to promote the people to go to a particular place, or that to join that event, or to visit that park or any amusement park, whatever it is. So that can be also be marketed. Then the fourth one, events, separately given. Here we can say all the events, maybe the show, isn't it, or the fair, exhibition, if anything is done, exhibition, book exhibition, or whatever may be the exhibition, then any sports events, especially the cricket show, isn't it, then, or the T20, whatever it is, any event can also be marketed. They can promote that one in order to bring many people to visit that particular place, that particular event. Okay. Then persons, don't think that they are advertising these persons and the people will buy them. No. Okay. Here, what is the meaning? The person, that marketing of goods and services are done through persons. Okay, that we know some eminent personalities or the famous people, maybe the cine field people or any sports stars, cine stars, then musicians. Okay, all these people will carry on that activity, that promoting activity. That's, we can say, that person also gets be promoted, isn't it? He too can increase his personality. Okay, then the sixth one, places are promoted. How it is also marketed. How, if maybe the real place, maybe the place or land or building. Nowadays they construct constructed houses, or the houses they are selling, isn't it? So constructed houses, buildings, all these can also be marketed any place, not to promote us to buy a particular place. They will say their particular features of that place. We have heard, isn't it, that particular near that place there is a college or there is a highway road, so transport facilities available, then a hospital is available. So all these are, they are promoting that place. Then properties, 7th one, properties. Properties we can say both, okay, that places, it is related to places only. The properties also they will promote. Here we can say the land, some plots, plot is available, okay, then the house, constructed houses, then any share, to buy a particular company share, then its debentures, then any mutual fund instruments. Mutual fund. They too can advertise. They too can promote their sales. Okay. Not only this land, plot, constructed house, shares, debentures, all these are also properties. We have learned it as securities, isn't it? So they are also promoted. Then the organizations. Organizations. Some organization, they will promote, you know, for example, if you see the playground of that T20 or wherever it is, if it is that cricket, there you can see some of the company's name in the digital. It will be displayed, digital display. So that by seeing that one, that type of organization is promoted. Okay, that will be done. This organization promotion will be done in a particular event. In that particular event only they can promote their organization, or they can adopt some villages. That also they may do. Adoption of villages. They may do some service for them. So all the people, those who are in that particular village, they will come to know that organization. So it is another kind of promotion. Okay, the organization itself is taking that sponsorship they may do in a particular event. That event may be that will be sponsored by that particular type of organization, or they can adopt some of the villages and they may do some service, maybe the medical service or whatever service they are needed, they may do. By that they are promoting, the name of that organization is promoted or marketed. Then information. This information, a recent one, because many nowadays the information of one organization may be used by another organization. For example, those who they do the telemarketing or through the phone they do the marketing, what they do, they get the information, they get the phone number from the BSNL or from the phone companies, and they will promote their marketing. So this data collected by one organization will be used by another organization. Example, we can say the libraries, those who have collected, that libraries will have their names, the phone numbers, everything, isn't it? So that information can be collected by the people, those who are doing marketing in that particular area. So this can be done. So that information collected by one company will be used by another company. Okay. Maybe the educational institution, then book publishers. Okay, all these people will get the information and that will be used by other companies. Okay, the last one is ideas. So nowadays we can say one idea can change the world, isn't it? That we say. So then if any new ideas, you know, that innovative or new ideas can be used, that can also be marketed. If we do in this way, we can work out. Okay, then we can improve awareness in the mind of people. Now many people, they send the WhatsApp messages, isn't it? We can say they are that innovative and attractive ideas can help the people to sell some of their products. Maybe the TV, how they sell, tell all the features of a particular commodity, and they are showing, and they show the display, then they pack the things and send them to ask us to take give the order, isn't it? So all these are done by the with the, this ideas only. Okay, now all the 10 that things that can be marketed we have learned. Now the role of a marketer, here four roles he has to play. Okay, first one, instigator. Second one, innovator. Integrator, implementer. What is an instigator? First we should know, it's a new term, isn't it? Instigator means one who causes to do something. He is the reason for everything. Okay, that means we can say like a promoter. Isn't it? So he is the one who is the cause to do something. So how he is cause to do something? Because in the definition itself we learned he will find out a particular set of consumers and we will introduce. He will find and he will supply those goods and service to those people. So he has to observe everything keenly in the beginning, which type of people need this type of product, and all the opportunities what and all he is having, how to implement them. So he is the one who does the initial activity. Only then he can supply those goods and services to them. Okay, then the innovator. Innovator means we have learned already, isn't it? He is the one who introduces something. Here he is the cause to do something, and he is the one who is starting here in the initial stages how to go and find out a particular group of people and their desires. He has to find out and everything. He has to implement them. Then the innovator means he has to introduce something new in the market as per the aspirations of the consumers, their wishes, the consumers' wishes. Or what he can do, he can often introduce a new model or new techniques he can introduce, because he is the one who is contacting the customers, and he is acting as a middleman between the customers and the industrialist or the producers. So he can convey the message easily to the producer, and if the consumers they wish to have any new model, that can be conveyed to the producers. So if the producers they introduce something, he is the one who is coming and contacting the people to sell them. So he is acting as an innovator. Then integrator. Integrator means he coordinates something. What he is coordinating? The same thing, innovator, isn't it? Because he is the one who coordinate the producer and the consumers. He is acting in between the, like a channel member, isn't it? He is one of the channel member, those who are between the producers and consumers. So he has to collect all the feedback, if any feedback from the consumers, that can be collected and that can be informed to the producers. So he is acting as a integrator. Then implementer. Implement means he has to perform that activity. He is coordinating and he is innovating, introducing some new methods, ideas. Then he coordinates the activities of the consumers and the producers. At the same time, he implement the things. If something is introduced by the producer, that will be marketed by the marketer, isn't it? It will be sold by the marketer. So he implements that, his ideas. Okay, the role of a consumer, role of a marketer, we have learned. Then the functions. What are the functions? A marketer has to do many functions, that duties. First, he has to gathering and analyzing marketing information. Isn't it? First, he has to gather and analyzing whether that product can be sold in that particular place. So, gathering and analyzing market information. That is the first point. Okay, then market planning. He has to do market planning. How much quantities can be sold in that particular market. So, all this will be planned by him. Then about the product designing and development. This after started the marketing only, this will be done. Okay, product designing and development. Then standardization and grading. Standardized products only will be sold in the market easily, isn't it? Graded products, we will say, grading. Graded product or standardized products by any institution, but in Indian Institute of that standardization, whether it is standardized by the authorized institution. Then packaging and labeling, whether it is done, packaging is done properly, otherwise it will be spoiled, isn't it? Then labeling, whether all the details are available in the label. Then branding, branded products, the branding is there. Then customer support service. That post selling service will be done, isn't it? If any, that particular product has any defect, that will be serviced freely. That one, customer support service. Then pricing of products. The pricing of products very important. If the price of a product is very high, that people may not be able to afford to buy. So the pricing must be reasonable. The pricing is also very important. And promotion and selling. That any additional promotional activities, that means the media through the TV or to the radio, if they have to give promotional activities or advertisement or any which type of advertisement they have to do, then the selling, then physical distribution, how to distribute the goods. in a particular place, or we have to appoint a dealer, or one exhibition they can conduct it to sell them. That is called physical distribution. Then transportation. For the physical distribution, we need the transport to carry the goods from the producer's place to the consumer's place. That is transportation. Then storage and warehousing. Because many products will be produced, and if we do not, if we are not able to sell all the goods that we have produced, we must store them in one storage. If it is that perishable products, we have to store them in the cold storage or a particular place where there is that it must be protected against rain, then storm, then heavy wind. Okay, so storage and warehousing is also necessary. The functions of marketing. So to market a product, all these functions must be carried on. Okay, students, now we will mark the question answers. Okay. The one word question, choose the correct answer. One who promotes or exchanges goods or services for money is called as marketer. Then marketer initially wants to know in the marketing qualification of the customer, quality of the product, background of the customers, needs of the customers. Then spot market is classified on the basis of transaction. Which one of the market deals in the purchase and sale of shares and debentures? Stock exchange market. Stock exchange market is also called securities market. Now marketer we have marked, I think. Now market we have marked, isn't it? Now define marketer, I have marked and given, isn't it? Define marketer in page number 116. Then mention any four differences between wholesale market and retail market. This one you can write and take. Okay, this one up to here, retail market, wholesale market, retail market, you mark and you can write and keep. Okay. Then what can be marketed in the market? That one, 116, page number 116. Today what we have learned, then any three role of marketer, that also four roles are there. Then marketer is an innovator, do you agree? Okay, there three, here one they have asked, same page 117. Then why customer support is needed to market? That customer support is there, no? In page number 100. So here this I have written in the book that you can write. Okay, here 4-5 points are there. Okay, this one is the, this you write and keep. Well, list down the functions of marketer. Here 117 it is. Then here this question, what is the your contribution to promote the market in the modern society? That is in the guide. Okay, guide 123. Here it is. Okay, this one. This here, 3 points are there. Okay, only this much you write in your notebook and keep. Okay, this one and this full page. Okay, this full page you have to write and keep. Okay, you read, understand and keep. Okay, students. So, mark these question answers and study this all the question answers. We have completed one lesson. All these are very short and important lessons. That is why I am taking you now. Okay, so don't postpone any studies. Do it daily. Only then you can complete your lessons. Okay, students, thank you very much.